research on different headaches and migraines is that this is the brainstem. This is the cerebellum on the back part of the brainstem. This is the part of the brain up here called the midbrain. This is the pons, and this is the medulla. And this is your brainstem that controls all of the autonomic function of your brain.
Okay.
Every research that's out there on headaches, migraines, everything else, they all know that the breakdown is in the rostral, meaning the upper portion of the brainstem. They're not sure exactly where, they just know it happens somewhere in this upper part of the brainstem, and this upper brainstem is associated with a fight or flight. That's why tension headaches, that's why when stress-induced headaches, etc. That's why for some people caffeine induces headaches. For some people, caffeine calms it down.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Not sure.
Mm-hmm.
So what we use with the Zook device is you have your outer ear here, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And then you have your ear canal, and then you have your tympanic membrane, and then you have all your apparatus inside this middle ear, where you have all your bones, and you have your cochlear, and you have your otolithic system, and all of your canals, the vestibular apparatus. And then these two, cochlear and vestibular, come together to create cranial nerve 8, which is the vestibular cochlear nerve. That vestibular cochlear nerve comes in and attaches right here if it's the vestibular system, and if it's the cochlear, it's about right here. That's where sound travels in. So what we're doing is there's also pressure gradients. There's different cranial nerves that do different parts, and like the different bones on these tympanic membrane are controlled by different cranial nerves. For one of them being cranial nerve 5 and cranial nerve 7, and those cranial nerve 5 is the trigeminal nucleus that goes right here and comes up into the midbrain and down into here. It's the largest nucleus inside the brainstem. And then cranial nerve 7, it's just the facial nerve, and cranial nerve 7, and it's up here. Okay, so what we're trying to do and what we've discovered just by what doctors have showed us is changing the pressure in here and shifting the pressure through this alters how this integration works. Do we know the details? We don't. We don't know any of the details yet. But what it does, what we don't know is all the details. What we do know is how it has an effect on that pressure, changing how that integration works. Because commonly, people will have tension on one side, pressure on one side. They have it, or it's wrapped around. There's these clinical diagnoses of headaches or tension or stress or anything else, but we're not sure what happens. What we do know is that this pons is very much the rest and digest part of the brain. And when you alter cranial nerve 5, 7, and 8, which 5, 7, and 8 all exist here in the pons, which then activates the rest and digest system, and you get a change. And why that change occurs, we don't have the details. At this point, no one has any details on this. This is just what we know, as we've seen through clinical here at the office, by putting in our wonderful Zook product, and it comes right in here, and this little flange is right here. That little pressure gradient changes, and it causes an activation or a depolarization within these nerves, which then sends signals to the brain that then alters the outcome. And people can get relief, they could get change, or nothing can happen. It just depends on if this system is causing their stress or their tension or whatever they may be, the symptoms associated with headaches and migraines.